the STEM Saturday event that's going on today is a partnership between the Summer Academy for students who are deaf and hard of hearing and the Eberly College of Science's Office of Science Outreach. And this event evolved from a half-day forensics-only event last year and to become a full day of different types of science workshops for the students this week. It's really important to us and to Summer Academy and the staff at OVR that fields like STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math are accessible to anybody who's interested. And so having these kind of partnership programs that expose students with various disabilities to different STEM fields and the possibilities that they hold for them is really important. So today they went through four different science workshops, the first being engineering focused. Kind of they worked with, did a cool game with lasers, lasers and mirrors, I'm trying to work on different properties of light. They then went to a biochemistry related session where they learned about the spread of disease and looked at their own cheek cells under a microscope. And then this afternoon they had two sessions, one that was chemistry focused where they talked about chemiluminescence, got to build their own photodetecting device, and also the last session was a forensics session where they learned about the science behind identifying fingerprints, and they got to do a lot with their own. So they've really gotten exposed to a wide variety of science throughout the day, and we're really hoping that they take something away, even if they don't become science majors in the future. We would just love for them to develop an appreciation for science and an understanding of why it might be important or useful to them in the future, and we wish them all the best of luck.
The reason we went ahead and partnered with Science U is because we wanted to expose STEM to the students who come to the Summer Academy. Recently, I found a research article related to the number of deaf and hard of hearing people who get a PhD compared to the number of hearing people who get a PhD specifically in STEM-related fields. What was really interesting is that the findings showed that around 11 to 15% of the people who get PhDs from the hearing community get it in STEM, compared to those who are deaf and hard of hearing, the people who get PhDs, only 0.13 to 0.19% of the people who are deaf and hard of hearing who earn PhDs are studying STEM-related fields. So there's just so many fewer deaf people involved with STEM-related fields from the top, you know, earning the PhDs. So that's an interesting bit of information. So coming here, we want to offer the opportunity to the deaf and hard of hearing people to understand that they can be involved with STEM-related fields just like hearing people.